tudo bem com vocês? Tudo bem com vocês? Eu estou muito, muito bem. Eu espero que vocês estão bem, tá bom, tá bem? Hoje a gente vai assistir um novo filme brasileiro. Tô muito curiosa porque esse vídeo vocês gostam. Obrigada a vocês. Beijos. A gente vai assistir Minha Mãe e Uma Peça, parte 1. I saw that there are 3 parts to this movie. So we're going to start with the first one, and I made a poll on Instagram asking if you guys wanted me to react to Minha Mãe e Uma Peça or Carandiru, because those are movies that have been in my inbox for a while now. So, and after all these heavy movies, I think it's time to do like a comedy to make it a little bit more light, you know, a little bit more like calm down, tranquilo. Today I will be watching Minha Mãe e Uma Peça. Dona Herminia is a middle-aged divorced woman and her ex-husband got in a relationship with a younger woman. Hyperactive, she does not leave her children Marcelina and Giuliano alone without realizing that they are already grown-ups. One day, after finding out that they consider her annoying, she decides to leave her home without warning, leaving everyone worried what might have happened. We're going to be watching it. I am super, super curious. I gotta say my expectations for this movie are kind of high because a lot of you guys were like, you have to watch this movie, it's so good. And honestly, I'm more into like the drama kind of stuff, like Tropa de Elite, Cidade de Deus. I'm more into those kinds of movies. We're gonna try another comedy. If you have not watched my O Auto da Compadecida react, I also watched O Auto da Compadecida. It's right here. And I have also watched Central do Brasil. It's also right here. Like, there's a button right here you can click. You can see my playlist of all the movies I've watched. Without any further ado, me and my boyfriend are going to watch this movie. I'll be coming back to you guys with my thoughts about this movie. I'm really excited. I'm really excited. I'm gonna try to make my boyfriend say the name. Minha mãe.
Minha mãe.
E uma.
E uma.
Peça.
Peça.
Minha mãe e uma peça.
Meu.
Meu. Minha mãe.
Minha mãe.
E uma peça.
E uma peça.
Minha mãe e uma peça.
Minha mãe e uma peça.
Ah, que lindo, né? Que lindo. Yes. Vai. Então, gente, meu Deus do céu, tô cansada, gente, tô cansada, é meia-noite aqui, tô cansada. So, I don't even know where to start with this movie. First of all, the plot, like, the whole movie was kind of simple, so it's not hard to explain, but I just have a lot of thoughts on this movie. Before I say anything, I just have to put out there that I really prefer O Auto da Compadecida. I do. Don't be mad at me for saying that. My humor is just more with O Auto da Compadecida than it is with this one. And I know a lot of people were telling me to watch this movie and I was super, super curious about it. And to be honest, it didn't really match my expectations. So basically, it all starts, the movie's kind of simple, like it all starts with the mom, Herminia, and she has a daughter and a son, Marcelina and Giuliano. And the mom, I gotta say, she was rough. She was a rough mom. She, like, later on in the movie, you will see that this woman does not have any patience for anyone. She is super straight. She will tell you what it's about. She's super honest, and I kind of had to get used to that in the beginning because she was like calling her daughter fat and a whale, and I was like, what? So then in a phone call, I have a problem saying her name, so I'm gonna call her Donna. Donna overheard Marcelina saying that she was a pain in the ass, she was annoying, that she was always like a trouble, and she got really hurt by that, by those words from her own daughter. So she decided to pack her shit up and leave. She was like, you know what, you guys don't like me? She packed her stuff, went out the door without telling anybody where she went. Turns out she went to Aunt Zelia for a couple days. She arrived and she said to Aunt Zelia, like, I cannot deal with these crianças anymore. Like, they don't appreciate me, they don't respect me, they don't like me, I am over it. I put so much work and effort into this and I'm not doing it anymore. So she stayed for a couple days there. So during the movie, you can see all the things that I've had, like, well, some of the things that have happened in their relationship. And one of the things that I was the most shocked about was when Marcelina, she snuck out of the house to go to a club, which turned out to be a pajama party. And she went there with Juliano and they were in pajamas. Well, Juliano was not in pajamas. He had to take off his pants and he was like, I'm in pajamas. If you have seen the movie, you know what scene I'm talking about. She goes on the stage to remove the DJ, takes the microphone, and just starts talking to her daughter, Marcelina, who is in the crowd, embarrassed, because she's like, oh, have you guys seen this girl? She looks disgusting, she wears the same shirt, blah, 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 just making her daughter ridiculous. At that point, I was like, I'm not sure if this is my humor. Like, the beginning of the movie was kind of like, I was really excited about the beginning of the movie, but during the movie, I was kind of like, it started to not match my humor anymore. Like, oh, after that competa, see that I had the complete opposite. I was like, I had a rough start because, like, all the slangs they were using, they have an accent, but then during the movie, I got to really, really enjoy. And here, I was like having a lot of fun in the beginning, and then it kind of went downhill during the movie, which is totally something personal. If you love this movie, I understand, like, it's hilarious. If this is your kind of humor, then I understand. And I also gotta say, I'm not fluent in Portuguese, and I saw someone commenting like, this movie is probably not as funny if you have to read it with subtitles. And I think that's it, because I could hear her talking super, 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 super fast. Like, at some point, I was like, whoa. And the English subtitles, they would go so fucking fast that I could not even read, you know? So at some point, I was like... So even like, I kind of like compared the two movies, O Alto da Compadecida and this one together, because O Alto da Compadecida is also super fast, but was like easier to understand, even though it had like a whole meaning. I just cannot explain it. I've tried and I'm thinking about it. I just have a preference for O Alto da Compadecida, and my boyfriend, he watched it with me, both movies. He really liked O Alto da Compadecida too. And this one, he was kind of like on the same level as me. Like, it was I wouldn't say it's a bad movie, but for me as a gringa, it got kind of like, it would be hard to watch because she would talk so fast and the lyric, like, I couldn't follow the movie anymore. And like, all these people, it's a very busy movie. And it also depends on what kind of humor you like. This was not really my type of humor, but if this is your type of humor, then it's totally fine. A lot of people are saying that this is like their favorite movie, that this is the best movie they've seen, like the best Brazilian comedy movie, which I totally respect. Like, I respect your thing. Please respect my opinion as well. I'm here to review movies, and I'm just being honest with you guys about this. So yes, it was not my favorite, but it was not bad. I just would not recommend it to a gringa, you know? I think I would recommend O Alto da Compadecida, even though it's more difficult, but has like more my type of humor. And this one was kind of long, like the script was not really something for me. So yeah, I don't know what to say anything else. I'm sorry if you are offended. I hope not. I'm just here to review movies, that's all. And obviously I'm gonna have movies that I like, and I'm gonna have movies that I don't like. And I'm not saying that I don't like this movie. I'm gonna put it in the middle. Yes, I'm gonna put it in the middle. And I think the main reason why I had a hard time watching it is because it was so fast. Então, gente, muito obrigada. Amo vocês demais. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any other movie recommendations for me, please leave them in the comments down below. I try to read as much comments as I can, because I want to watch so much more movies, because we're in quarantine right now and I could watch a lot of movies and it will help my Portuguese. So, yes. Amo vocês demais. Muito obrigada, gente. Até o próximo. Seguir meu Instagram. Inscrever no meu canal. Tudo, tudo, tudo. Vocês sabem, né? E beijo pra vocês. Tchau.